Hey there, Kootenayboy here. Today we're going to do a quick do-it-yourself for a Xbox One cooler. You know, if you're running some of those marathon gaming sessions and you worry about your Xbox or console getting too hot and don't want to spring for one of the fancy pre-made models that you can get off just about anywhere online, or you just, like myself, would rather do it yourself, create a little project and whatnot, this is an easy, quick way to do it. First of all, you're going to need a computer fan. There's several different types. Some of them come with heat shrouds and whatnot on them. Others are for the case themselves, the little tiny ones. Some, if you had got one out of a server, they can even be quite large, also noisy. I like this one. I bought it brand new for another project and I've used it before for this purpose. The other thing you're going to need is a regular USB cable. Just a normal one. Inside there's a multitude of wires usually, but for our purposes the only ones you're going to really use are the red and the black on this one. If you have a multimeter you can find out what it is pretty quick. Just use one of these AC adapters and plug it in, hook it up to the multimeter, and it'll tell you usually 5 volts coming out. Computer fans are usually run on the 12 volt kind of a range, as you can see on this one, but 5 volts does work really well with them. I've used this one before, as you can see by the dust, and it's never failed me. And the USB output on your Xbox One console just happens to be 5 volts as well, so there's no problem with that. Basically, you're going to take your console or your fan and you're going to hook your wires up, red to red, black to black kind of a deal, which is pretty standard stuff. If you've done any wiring at all, it's kind of ingrained in you to do it that way. And we'll put the black one on here as well. This works really well. Usually they're fairly quiet. Not too much of a problem there. The console's USB ports on the Xbox One, anyway, they usually run 24/7. They're never actually off. So you will have to either unplug it or let it run all the time, which doesn't really hurt it, but it can create a little bit more dust than what you might want inside. So keep that in mind when you're doing it. See, I've just quickly soldered those two red to red, black to black together on there. And you then fold them back as so. Before I went ahead and did this, I already put heat shrink over the wires, so that when I was ready to do the actual connections on it, they would already have the heat shrink on them. So you pull the heat shrink over top of them. This one's being a little tricky because I used a smaller heat shrink than what I normally should have. Make sure you bend them with the portion that you're soldered facing away from where you're pushing the heat shrink on, and that will help it to go on a little easier. This one, as you can see, is being a little bit of a problem. You can buy the coolers online just about anywhere, actually. Amazon, of course, any of those kind of places. But I like to do things myself sometimes, and I have parts kicking around, so figure why not. Just give those a quick heat shrink on them. These you don't really need. You can fold them back or cut them right off depending on what you want to do. I just kind of fold them back in case I have another use for this later on and I want to reuse it. I don't want to have to cut the wires and all that, so pull your heat shrink over top of everything. And I'll do a bit of a tape up job on the other side, whatnot for it. Just kind of work it over, careful not to pull too hard on everything. Don't want to destroy everything there. Alright, now, again with that handy dandy adapter to go into the wall. plug that in. And if you've done the job correctly, you'll have a fan that you can now place directly on the top of your console or on the side port plug in if you prefer. I use the top usually, and it will draw more air through than the stock fan and keep your console cooler a lot longer. No glitches and stuff like that happening. If you really want to get fancy with it, you can always add something like this that I got out of another older tower. It's a thermostat, adjustable, so I can adjust the thermostat temperature and whatnot on it, and it'll kick on and off as needed. So that's pretty much it. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. Please like and subscribe if you found this video useful, and have a great day. Thanks.